गाइस वेलकम टू डिनोज वर्ल्ड। अभी अभी डिनो भाई नहाए हैं वो भी डर्ट वाटर में थैंक्स टू CB200X, क्योंकि वी वर जस्ट पुटिंग इट थ्रू इट्स स्पेसेस एंड इट्स कम आउट ब्यूटिफुली, लाइट वेट, निम्बल, एजाइल एंड रनिंग यू थ्रू क्विकली द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द हॉर्नेट एंड दिस वन। नाउ दिस इज काइंड ऑफ एन एडवेंचर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट होंडा ट्राइड टू ऑफर विद द CB200X व्हेन कंपेयर टू द हॉर्नेट स्ट्रीट फाइटर। नाउ द हॉर्नेट स्ट्रीट फाइटर वॉज एन एब्सोल्यूट डिलाइट व्हेन आई रिव्यूड इट, आई एब्सोल्यूटली लव्ड इट। दे ट्राई टू ऑफर मोर वैल्यू for the money that they demand. It's kind of a game changing launch, and one thing that I liked about the Hornet Street Fighter was the extra thing that they were trying to, extra features or the extra power, the extra bit of almost everything that they were trying to offer with the Street Fighter. But now this is again going the extra mile. lot too many extras happening now currently, but anyway, so you have this quarter fairing slapped on here. Now Honda have not claimed about long travel suspension, but you can see there is some kind of visual difference, so I feel it is long travel suspension. However, ground clearance remains the same at 167 mm when compared to the Hornet, so it doesn't change. That is kind of a downer. If only they had upped the ground clearance to 200 mm, this would have been a beautiful off-roading machine. Again, proper, you know, suspension tweaks at the rear also could have done wonders. As it is, this bike is absolutely, stellar in terms of being lightweight and nimble and, easy to flick around and agile. Now, running you through the features, up front you have this signature style LED headlamp, which is kind of screams Hornet, but you now also get this extra bit of windscreen, which does offer good wind protection. Highlight, however, is the integrated turn indicators come with hazard lights, so it is touring equipped is what I feel. Another thing, you have this front beak kind of inspired by the CB500X maybe, but it does remind you of the CB500X when you look at it. But CB500X is a phenomenal off-roading machine. The only downer was the pricing. If only they can price it competitively, it's going to steal the show. But anyway, coming back to the highlights, highlights here for the mudguard, the detailing here looks good. Gold anodized USD forks, I think. Now, there's no specification that this is 41 mm or 37 mm. Whatever these are, they are offering good front end feel even while tackling off-roading and even while cruising at around 110 km/h. You can cruise at around 105 to 110 km/h effortlessly on this. Another thing are the tires. Now, you get block pattern tires as you can see here. So, these are MRF Zapper tires, but you get block pattern tires. If only they had offered 19-inch front wheel, it would have again been kind of a proper off-roading machine. But 17-inch wheels are also able to do the thing because the chassis orientation is really good. Apart from that, coming over here, overall fit and finish and build quality is good. You get aluminium levers here. I wish they had offered open teethed rider foot pegs to make it more pro off-roading. So overall, this is a touring machine is what I can say. You also get this neatly laid out engine cowl, which gets a slightly different design when compared to the Street Fighter. I love the 3D badging here, gives a premium feel, the CB200X kind of a graphic here. And the tank again is slightly smaller. I wish they had offered a bigger tank with larger tank capacity to offer more tank range. Seat is very comfortable, very spacious, and even the pillion seat is nice and easily accommodating for the pillion, for ladies to hop on easily without having to jump around. But anyway, moving to the switch gear, we have all the relevant switches here: high beam flasher, engine kill switch, hazard lights, which is really crucial for those who like to tour on this. Speedo console, again similar to the Hornet 2.0. you can see the startup animation. You have all the relevant info here. You have the speedo, taco, and the time, and overall you have the gear position indicator, fuel indicator, and what else do we have here? Trip A, trip B, and battery volt indicator. That's also really good. Let's quickly hear the sound of the bike. I love the clutch feel. So that was the exhaust note. Let's come around here. I love the handguards, they really do the job. Short and stubby exhaust right here. Sounds really good. Petal discs, both front and rear. Nissan calipers, 220mm disc at the back, and 276mm disc at the front, pedal disc again, Nissan caliper, single channel ABS, means ABS is operational only on the front wheel, which is what we want in an off-roader. We want the rear wheel to spin freely, like, you know, a rapper running through his lyrics freely. Then you have the 140 section block pattern rear tire as well. Again, good tread pattern here to tackle dirt roads. So that's pretty much it. Powering the bike, 184.4 cc, single cylinder fuel injected BS6 compliant engine, puts out around 17 bhp of max power, 16.2 newton meters of max torque, 5-speed gearbox. So this is a overview of the CB200X. Next, we're going to take it out on the tarmac and then off-road, see how I got this shower. Maybe you would have seen it in the intro as well. Let's hit the road now. Hello there guys, welcome to Dino's World. Today I feature the CB200X. You guys kept requesting me to feature this as soon as possible. Well, is this a proper adventure tourer or not? And how good is this a proposition in its price segment? So let's find out what kind of changes have Honda given it to make it a capable touring machine, and does it make any difference in the real world conditions? Let's find out. First of all, the seating is very comfortable. Just checking for the cruising speed. You can cruise at 105 effortlessly without straining the engine. Push it up to 110 as well. This is a new bike, so once the engine brakes in, I think 105 to 110 is a capable cruising speed for this motorcycle, which is very, very good. First of all, the same Hornet engine, 184.4cc single fuel injected BS6 compliant engine. Now this, does it get long travel suspension is a question mark, because Honda have not emphasized on that. But one thing I like is the seating posture. The handlebar is definitely raised. The quarter fairing really gives it an adventure bike stance, and the front windshield is well bolted on. It doesn't flutter at high speeds, and it does offer good wind protection. Another good element is the hand guards. They really shield your hand well from the wind and any kind of dust or anything that comes in the way. And you have turn indicators integrated into the hand guards, so which gives the bike a distinctive look, and also you know, it adds on to the functionality along with the form factor. So overall, I feel, is it worthy enough to call it the CB500X's younger sibling? Honestly, no, because the CB500X is a beautiful machine. It's a proper adventure bike. It's an out and out fun oriented bike, and I absolutely loved riding it. The only glitch it has is the pricing. If only Honda can price it around 6 lakhs price range on road, it is gonna sell like crazy. I mean, Honda is gonna have a tough time supplying that motorcycle. That's how the demand is gonna rise, because it's a beautiful machine, the 500X. Now this one is really good in and of itself. In this price range, I think 1,44,000 ex-showroom here in Hyderabad is what I'm told by the showroom guys. I'll try and put the pricing, exact pricing, on the screen. The proposition as it is, the engine is super peppy, nice and responsive. So I love the response of the engine. Another good thing is the seating posture. Raised handlebar, you can see the risers here on the for the handlebar, significantly raised, very relaxed upright seating posture, and the seat is perfectly cushioned. The clutch is super light, the throttle response is phenomenal thanks to the dual throttle cable setup. The throttle response is crisp and consistent throughout, and 17 bhp
and 16.2 newton meters of torque, 5-speed gearbox, but still it has a good meaty mid-range, nice punchy mid-range, which you can enjoy riding through the city streets. Very lightweight and easy to handle, that's another major plus. Especially when you're touring, you need a lightweight machine such that the weight of the machine doesn't wear you down with time. Another thing is, we don't get 19-inch front wheel, we still continue to get 17-inch wheels at both ends, but we do get block pattern tires or on-road off-road tires. Now this, can it handle extreme off-roading? Definitely no, because the ground clearance remains the same, 167mm for both regular Hornet and this one. The regular Hornet, I absolutely loved reviewing it, because a super slick street fighter, nice punchy peppy responsive engine. We have the same engine plonked in here, but you don't feel that the added weight has made any difference. In fact, this feels super lightweight to flick around, to play around on the dirt. Single channel ABS, again, it's an advantage. On an adventure bike, it's an advantage. Or on an off-road bike, it's an advantage, because you anyhow want the rear wheel to spin freely. So ABS is operational only on the front wheel. You do get dual disc setup, however. 276mm pedal disc up front, 220mm pedal disc at the back. Suspension, you get USD forks, gold anodized forks, really premium, but I'm not sure about the diameter, maybe 37mm or maybe 41mm, I'm not sure, but you can confirm that. And long travel suspension has also not been specified, so that is one thing you need to note. But overall, I feel if you want, you're looking for a comfortable adventure bike to start with, I think this is the bike. And for off-roading machines, you need that initial pickup and good torque, bottom end torque. So this one has that. If only they had offered a 19-inch front wheel, it would have really made a world of difference. But anyway, for street touring, this really does fit the bill. Apart from that, suspension is good for city use, and this can serve as a good all-round machine for you. So that is another major plus. You need not have another secondary bike. You can have one do-it-all bike for touring, for weekend getaways, and for daily office commutes. Mileage is another major plus point for Honda motorcycles. You have fuel injection, so the air-fuel mixture is more precise, so every drop of fuel is optimized, so the fuel efficiency is going to be more. Apart from that, you also have decent power figures. So it's not screaming power figures, but the way they have tuned the engine is what makes things interesting. So it is really, really responsive and enjoyable. Now let's try and take it off-road and just check as to how well it performs off-road. Okay guys, so now we are here at my regular off-roading testing spot. So let's be a little gentle. Yeah. Off we go. How does it handle? It's pretty good actually. Because of the peppy nature, it's really just flying across these small dirt patches. Now you know, once you've done Ladakh, how crazy it can get in terms of off-roading, but still, this is decent enough. If your bike can handle this, oh. So overall, I feel it's handling, keeping up with these water puddles pretty well, and this dirt stretch is dreaded by people because Google Maps shows this as a road and then people come and get stuck here. But anyway, the best part about this bike is it's lightweight and flickable, and that good bottom end punch is what makes things all the more interesting and easy to, you know, maneuver and handle and flick around and do whatever you want. Oh my god, this is a huge one. So that's pretty much it. I'm having fun. As the day comes to an end, as the sun sets, I'll be riding into the horizon. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Until then, take care, God bless, and ride safe.